स्टूडेंट्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल माई सेल्फ प्रवीण कुमार मल्लिक एंड आई वेलकम टू यू ऑल ऑफ यू टू माई वीडियो चैनल. ओके, टूडे वी विल डू द एक्सरसाइज ऑफ आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर रेशनल नंबर इन क्लास 8. वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट द रेशनल नंबर एंड ऑल्सो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड टू एक्सरसाइज फ्रॉम दिस यूनिट. नाउ वी विल डू द लास्ट एक्सरसाइज. Okay, so before starting this exercise, just we will revise the previous things, and we have already learned how to insert some rational numbers and how can we convert the rational number into decimal number and decimal number into rational numbers. And in exercise 1C, that is a chapter of irrational number, and in irrational numbers, how can we convert the irrational number to the decimal form, as well as how can we compare two irrational number, and also how can we simplify the irrational numbers, and how to insert some rational and irrational number in between two irrational numbers. So let's start the exercise. Okay, and my request is, if you have not seen my previous videos, then first see that those videos, then watch this video. If you have not seen those videos, then it is very difficult for you to understand all those things. Okay, so let's start the exercise. Question number 1, and mind it, I will not do all the questions. I will not solve all the questions, because if I will solve all the questions, then you will not do anything. Okay, so I will solve only some of the bits of every questions. Okay, so in first question number 1, there are 8 bits, but we will do only 2 or 3 bits. Okay, so examine whether the following numbers are rational or irrational. That means some number is given and we have to check those numbers are rational or not rational. Okay, so first bit is root over of 52, and suppose third bit is 2 root 5 into 5 root 2, and sixth bit is root 48 plus 14 minus 4 root 3, and last bit we will do last bit 5 root 3 divided by root 6 whole square. Okay, so in question number 1 we will do these things, these questions. Okay, first bit 1, what is given? 52, root over of 52, and we have to check whether it is rational or irrational number. So how can we check this number root 52? So first of all, we have to find out the factorization of 52. Okay, so 52, when we factorize this number 52, 2, then it will be 26, then again 2, it is 13. So 13 is a prime number. That means we can write that root over of 52 equal to 2 into 2 into 13. Here we can see that there are 2 numbers of 2. That means here is a pair of 2. So in root over, the pair of 2 will become only 2, and this is single digit, that means it will again root 13. So here it is the product of 2 numbers, one is rational number and another one is irrational number, and we have already known that the product of 2 numbers, one rational and irrational number, the product of rational number and irrational number is always a rational number. That means it is an irrational number. Okay, so come to second bit. Second bit is 2 root 5 into 5 root 2. So your answer is, again, this is the product of 2 numbers. One is 2 root 5 and second one is 5 root 2. Again, simplify it. 2 into root 5 into 5 into root 2, which is equal to, multiply the rational number first, 2 into 5 into root 5 into root 2, which is equal to 2 into 5 equal to 10, and root 5 into root 2 equal to root 10. So here this is again the result is the product of one rational number and one irrational number. So the product of one rational number and one irrational number is always rational number. Okay. So come to third bit. Third bit equal to root 48 plus 14 minus 4 root 3. So here 14 is a rational number and 4 root 3, it cannot be simplified anymore. Because 4 is rational number and 3 is irrational number, root 3 is irrational number and 3 is in the simplest form. We cannot simplify more. So now we have to only simplify the value of root 48. Okay. So root 48 equal to 48 first factorize root 48. So 48 to 2, 24, then again 2, 12, again 2, 6, again 2, 3. So here we can write that root 48 equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 plus 14 minus 4 root 3. Here you can see that there is a pair of 2 and another pair of 2. So for this pair of 2 we can write 2 and for this pair of 2 we can write again 2. And this is a single 3, so it will be root 3. Okay, plus 14 minus 4 root 3. Here the product of 2 into 2 root 3 is equal to 4 root 3 plus 14 minus 4 root 3. Here you can see that 4 root 3 and 4 root 3 will be cancelled. So our final answer is 14, which is a rational number. Okay. Now we will do the question number bit 6. 5 root 3 by root 6 whole square. Okay. So here 5 root 3 means 5 root 3 divided by root 6 means root over of 2 into 3 whole square, which is equals to 5 root 3 divided by root 2 into root 3 whole square. Here root 3 and root 3 can be cancelled. The result is 5 by root 2 whole square is equals to 5 into 5 divided by root 2 into root 2 equal to 25 by root 2 into 2 is equal to 2. So it is an rational number. Okay. So I have completed question number 1. Just like this, we can complete all the bits. There are 8 bits in question number 1. Okay. So now, question number 2. Question number 2. In question number 2 also there are 8 bits. We will do 4 bits. So first of bit 1, 3 plus root 7 whole square. 3 plus root 7 whole square bit. Suppose bit 3rd. Bit 3rd, 5 root 6, 5 root 6 minus 3 root 7, 3 root 7 whole square, and bit 5 is 2 root 3 plus 2 root 3 plus 4 root 5, 4 root 5 into 2 root 3 minus 4 root 5, 2 root 3 minus 4 root 5. Okay. And we will want sum of 7 and 8. Let us take bit 7. 22 plus 8 root 6. 8 root 6 whole root. We have to, same things, we have to check whether these numbers are rational or irrational. So we have to first simplify, then we have to compare that it is rational or irrational. And we must know that what is rational and what is irrational numbers. We definitely know the the basic difference between rational and irrational. The basic difference is rational number, whose the number which can be expressed in the form of p by q, where p and q both are integers and q should not be zero. And a number, if it is not a rational number, then that is an irrational number. Okay. So first of all, 3 plus root 7 whole square, bit 1. Okay. So 3 plus root 7 whole square. Here we can use the formula of a plus b whole square. Okay, so a plus b whole square equal to how much? A plus b whole square equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. This is very important formula. Okay, so what we will get? Let 3 as a, 3 as a and root 7 as b. Then a plus b whole square. Now we will put the formula a square. A means 3 square plus b square means b is root 7. Root 7 whole square plus 2 into a means 3 into b means root 7. Okay, so our final answer is 3 square means 9 plus root 7 whole square means root 7 into root 7. Already I have told you root 7 into root 7 is how much? 7. Okay, because root 7 into root 7 equal to 7 into 7 root. Okay, root over of 7 into 7. Here we have got a pair of 7, the result will be only 7. So 3 square equal to 9 and root 7 whole square equal to 7 plus 2 into 3 into root 7. So these are known as the rational number. So we can write that 2 into 3 is 6 and this is root 7. Here the final answer is 16 plus 6 root 7. So here we can see that root 7 is an irrational number and the product of 6 and root 7, that means 6 root 7 is again an irrational number. And this is a rational number. The sum of one rational number and one irrational number is always irrational number. So our final answer is irrational number. Similarly, bit 3 is 5 root 6 minus 3 root 7 whole square. Again, we can put the formula for A here. If we treat that 5 root 6 as A and 3 root 7 as B, then we can see that here we can put the formula of A minus B whole square. And what is the formula for A minus B? A minus B whole square equal to A square plus B square minus 2AB. So put this formula A square plus B square minus 2AB. Here A, the value of A equal to 5 root 6 and the value of B equal to 3 root 7 equal to 5 root 6 whole square plus 3 root 7 whole square minus 2 into 5 root 6 into 3 root 7. Okay, so here 5 root 6 whole square. So what is the value of 5 root 6 whole square? That means 5 root 6 into 5 root 6. The answer is 5 into 5, 25 into 6 into root 6 into root 6 equal to 6. The answer is 150. Okay, so here the 5 root 6 whole square equal to 150. Similarly, 3 root 7 whole square. 3 root 7 whole square equal to 3 root 7 into 3 root 7, which is equal to 3 into 3 equal to 9 into 7, root 7 into root 7 equal to 7, which is equal to 63. So plus 63. Again, 2 into 5 root 6 into 3 root 7. The rational number is 2, 5 and 3. The result is 2 into 5 equal to 10. 10 into 3 equal to 30. So minus 30. So root 6 into root 7 equal to root 42. Our final answer is 150 plus 63. These two numbers are rational numbers. So the result is 150 plus 63 equal to 213 minus 30 root 42. Okay, so root 42 is an irrational number or rational number. So factorize it, 42, that means 2, and 21, that means 3 into 7. So 42 root over of 42, that means root over of 2 into 3 into 7. Here you can see that all the numbers are single. There is no pair of numbers. So the total is root 42 is an irrational number. This is an irrational number. So the product is whole product is irrational number. And the sum and a subtraction of rational and irrational number is irrational number. Okay. Now, which question? 7. Bit 7. 20. Bit 5. Bit 5. What is the question? 2 root 3 plus 4 root 5 into 2 root 3 minus 4 root 5. Okay. Here another one formula can be, we can use that. One thing, student, if we have an idea about this formula, then we can do it easily. Okay, if you don't know the about the formula, then you can simplify, you can simply multiply those numbers and we can get the same result. The result will be same. But if we put the formula or if we use the formula, then we can get the answer very easily and very shortly. So here let 2 root 3 as A and 4 root 5 as B. So here again 2 root 3 that means A, 4 root 5 means B. So here A plus B and here A minus B. So what is the formula of A plus B into A minus B? The formula is A plus B into A minus B is equals to A square minus B square. So we will now put this formula A square minus B square. So A square minus B square means A is 2 root 3 and B is 4 root 5. That is 2 root 3 whole square minus 4 root 5 whole square. Okay. So our result is 2 root 3 whole square means 2 root 3 into 2 root 3. So 2 into 2 equal to 4 and root 3 into root 3 equal to 3. So 4 into 3. Okay. Plus. Sorry. Completed. And 4 root 5 whole square. What is the value of 4 root 5 whole square? So 4 root 5 into 4 root 5. What is the result? 4 into 4 equal to 16 and root 5 into root 5 equal to 5. So minus 16 into 5. The result is 4 into 3 equal to 12 minus 16 into 5 equal to 80. So our answer equal to minus 68. Okay. So again minus 68 is a rational number. Okay. So final question is, this is very important last question, which is a very important question. Root 22 plus 8 root 6. Now, root 22 plus 8 root 6 is an irrational or rational? It is so difficult to find out because root over one root over is under any another root over. So we can't imagine that what type of number it will be. So for solving these things, we have to take an assumptions. Let, what is the assumption? Let 22 plus 8 root 6 is equals to root A plus root B whole square. Okay. So we have to take this assumption. Okay. So when root A plus root B whole square is how much? We know that the formula of A plus B whole square equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB. That means root A whole square plus root B whole square minus 2 into root A into root B, which is equals to A, root A whole square means root A into root A, which is equals to A, plus root B whole square means B minus 2 root over of A B. Okay. So this value is how much? 22 plus 8 root 6. Okay. So now here these two parts are rational part and this is an irrational part. Okay. So in this equations, this is also the rational part and this is irrational part. Now then compare the rational part with the rational part and irrational part with irrational part. We will get the value of A plus B is equals to 22. Sorry. A plus B is equals to how much? 22 and root 2 root AB. Why minus here? Sorry. I have written here the negative sign here. Sorry, it is plus. So 2AB is equals to 8 root 6. Yes or no? Root A plus root B whole square equal root A whole square plus root B whole square plus 2 into root A into root B. Just like this formula. Okay. So our answer is A plus B equal to 22 and root 2 root AB is equals to 8 root 6. Implies that AB root over is equals to 8 root 6 by 2 is equals to 4 root 6. Implies that AB is equals to 4 root 6 whole square. That means if we do the squaring both the sides, we will get root AB whole square means AB is equals to 4 root 6 whole square means how much? 4 root 6 into 4 root 6. The answer is 4 into 4 equal to 16 into root 6 into root 6 equal to 6. The answer is 96. Okay. So here we have got the value of A plus B equal to 22 and AB is equals to 96. By these two things, we can find out the value of A and B. In class 7, we have already learned these things, how to find out the value of A and B. Okay? So, here, what we have got? A plus B is equals to 22 and AB is equals to 96. Okay? So, by using formula, which formula? A minus B whole square is equals to A plus B whole square minus 4AB. That is a formula that A minus B whole square equal to A plus B whole square minus 4AB. That means A minus B whole square is equal to A plus B whole square. A plus the value of A plus B equal to 22. So 22 whole square minus 4 into AB is equal to 96. The answer is 22 whole square means 484. That means 22 into 22, which is equal to 484 minus 4 into 96. 4 into 96 means 4, 6 are 24, 4 and 2 carry 4 times 36 plus 2, 38. The answer is 100. 484 minus 384 equal to 100. So A minus B whole square is equal to 100. Now taking the root over both the side, we will get A minus B whole square root over equal to root over of 100. The result is A minus B is equal to the root over of 100 equal to 10. So, we have got here A plus minus B equal to 10 and we have A plus B equal to 22. Now, A plus B is equal to 22 and A minus B is equal to 10. By adding those numbers, we will get, it will be cancelled. So, 2A is equal to 32, A is equal to 32 by 2 is equal to 16. And put the value of A in the equation, A plus B is equal to 22, 16 plus B is equal to 22, B is equal to 22 minus 16 is equal to 6. Okay, so here we have got the value of A is equal to 16 and B is equal to 6. Now, come to our assumption. We have taken that assumption is, what we have taken the assumption? 22 plus 8 root 6 is equal to root A plus root B whole square. This was our assumptions. Now put the value of these things. Okay. So when we put the value of these things, what we will get? The value of A is equal to 16 and B is equal to 6. So 22 plus 8 root 6 is equal to root A plus root B whole square. This is the assumption that we have taken. So now put the value of A is equal to 16 and B equal to 6, which is equal to root 16 plus root 6 whole square is equal to 4 plus root 6 whole square. Okay. So now, if the value of these things is equal to this, then our result, our aim is to find out the value of root over of 28 plus root 8 root 6. So root over of 22 plus 8 root 6 is equal to root over of this value is equal to this much. So, root over of 4 plus root 6 whole square. So, again 4 plus root 6 whole square, again root over is equal to 4 plus root 6. So, this is our final answer. So, root over of 22 plus 8 root 6 is equal to 4 plus root 6. Again here, we have got 4 is an rational number and root 6 is an irrational number. So, the sum of one rational number and one irrational number is always irrational number. So, this final answer is irrational number. Okay. So, in this way, we can do all the questions of question number 3, bit 1. So, 2 root 3 and 3 root 2. 2 root 3 and 3 root 2. And we will do the question number bit 2. Bit 2 is 4 5 root cube root of 5 and 5 cube root of 3. And another question, question number 3, cube root of 3 and 4th root of 4 and 4th root of 4. So while comparing these two numbers, first of all, we have to know the process how we will compare them. Okay, so there is a relation between two numbers a and b such that if a square is less than b square, then a less than b. Okay, similarly, if a q is less than b q, then also we can write that a less than b. And if a to the power n less than b to the power n, then we can conclude that a less than b. And this is vice versa. That means if we will do it oppositely. That means if b square is less than a square, then b is less than a. Similarly, bq is less than aq, then b is less than a. And similarly, if b to the power n less than a to the power n, then b less than a. So we have to put this formula and this assumption here. Okay? So 2 root 3 and 3 root 2. So here the power of 3. Here the power of 3. We have already learned in class 7 about the formula of the exponent and about the exponent number. Okay? So the power root over 3, that means 2 into 3 to the power 1 by 2. And here 3 root 2 means 3 into 2 to the power 1 by 2. So now we have to compare, not compare a and b. We will compare between a square and b square. That means now we will compare between the square of this number and this number. Okay, so let us compare. Let us compare between square of 2 into 3 to the power 1 by 2 and 3 into 2 to the power 1 by 2. So the square of these numbers, we will compare between the square of these numbers. That means 2, 3 to the power 1 by 2 into the square equal to how much? 2 into 2 into 3 to the power 1 by 2 into 3 to the power 1 by 2. We can write also root 3 into root 3 also. Same thing, 2 to 3 to the power 1 by 2 means root 3, and again 3 to the power 1 by 3 means root 3. So answer is 2 into 2 equal to 4 and root 3 into root 3 equal to 3, which is equals to 12. Similarly, 3 2 into 2 to the power 1 by 2 is square is equals to 3 into 3 into 2 to the power 1 by 2 into 2 to the power 1 by 2, which is equals to 3 into 3 equal to 9 into 2 to the power 1 by 2 into 2 to the power 1 by 2, which is equals to 2 to the power 1 by 2 means 2, which is equals to 18. So this is very normal thing. 2 to the power 1 by 2 means root 2. And 2 to the power, again 1 by 2 means root 2. Root 2 into root 2 equal to 2, already we have learned. So, don't confuse in between these things. So, 9 into 2 equal to 18. Now, we can easily compare 12 and 18. So, we know that 12 is less than 18. So, 12 is the square of 3 root 2. So, square 2 root 3 square. Yes or no? Is less than 3 root 2 square. So, implies that our conclusion will be 2 root 3 is less than 3 root 2. Okay? Now, we will compare the second numbers. Okay? So, why we have done the square? That means our aim is not to do the square only. Our aim is to convert these things into rational form. Okay, so here 4 root cube 5, that means 4 into 5 to the power 1 by 3, and 5 root cube 3 is equals to how much? 5 into 3 to the power 1 by 3. So when we compare these numbers, then we have to compare between the cube a cube and b cube, the cube of these two numbers, because if we will find out the cube of this number, then it will become the rational. First of all, our aim is to turn these numbers into rational numbers. Then we will compare. Okay? So, first of all, 4 into 5 to the power 1 by 3 whole to the power 3 is equals to 4 into 4 into 4 into 5 to the power 1 by 3 into 5 to the power 1 by 3 into 5 to the power 1 by 3. The result is 4 into 4 into 4 equal to 64, into the result is 5, which is equals to 320. Okay, same 5 cube root of 3 whole cube, which is equals to 5 into 5 into 5 into 3 to the power 1 by 3 into 3 to the power 1 by 3 into 3 to the power 1 by 3. The result is 5 into 5 into 5 equals 125 into 3, which is equals to 375. Now, we can easily compare between 320 and 375. The result is 320 is less than 375. That means 4 cube root of 5 whole cube is less than 5 root cube of 3 whole cube. Implies that 4 root cube of 5 is less than 5 root cube of 3. Okay? So now we will do the question number 3. Here you can see that here power means 3 to the power 1 by 3, here 4 to the power 1 by 4. The power are not same. So this is important. So when the power are not same, then what we have to do? Our first aim to convert this number into rational form. Okay. So first of all, how we will convert these things into rational form? So here 3 to the power root cube 3 means 3 to the power 1 by 3 and root 4th root of 4 is equal to 4 to the power 1 by 4. Here the power are not same. So for these things we have to find the LCM of denominator. So what is the denominator 3 and 4? So 3 and 4 LCM. It will not be divisible by any other number. So 3 into 4 equal to 12. 12 is the LCM. So multiply the LCM. Multiply the LCM with the power of these numbers. So that means we have to find out 3 to the power 1 by 3 whole to the power 12. Okay. So which is equals to find out the 12th power of these both numbers. So if we find out the 12th power of these numbers, then the power will convert it to rational form. That means 3 to the power 1 by 3 whole to the power 12 equal to 3 to the power 1 by 3 into 12. It will be cancelled. 4 is equal to 3 to the power 4, which is equal to 3 into 3 into 3 into 3, which is equal to 81. Similarly, 4 to the power 1 by 4 whole to the power 12 is equal to 4 to the power 1 by 4 into 12. So it will be cancelled, equal to 4 to the power 3 equal to 4 into 4 into 4. The result is 64. That means we can compare that 81 and 64. Which one is greater? 81 is greater than 64. So we can conclude that 81 is greater than 64. That means 3 to the power 1 by 3 whole to the power 12 is greater than 4 to the power 1 by 4 whole to the power 12. So I can conclude that 3 to the power 1 by 3 is greater than 4 to the power 1 by 4. Okay, completed. So here we have completed question number 3, all bits of the question number 3. Now we will do the question number 4, 5, 6, 7. And just like 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 are same. So we will do only 4, question number 4, question number 5, question number 6 and question number 7. And 8, 9, 10, 11 you will do. Okay, because the numbers are, the questions are same. So question number 4. What is the question? Find two irrational number. Such that their sum is is irrational. Already we have discussed in previous video that how can we take two irrational numbers such that their sum will be rationals. The form is, if we will take two irrational numbers such that their irrational part is equal but in opposite in sign. Okay, so its form is a plus root b and c minus root b. If we take two number like this, then their sum will be a rational number. For an example, 5 plus root 3 and 8 minus root 3. If we add them, then result will be 5 plus root 3 plus 8 minus root 3. And root 3 root 3 will cancel. So answer is 16, which is a rational number. Okay. In similar way also we can take another example. So 3 plus 2 root 5 and 5 minus 2 root 5. So if we add them, the result will be 3 plus 2 root 5 plus 5 minus 2 root 5. So 2 root 5 cancel. The answer is 8. Okay, which is a rational number. So if you will take this type of number, then their sum will be a rational number. Okay, understood? So we will go for the question number 5. In question number 5, the question is, find two irrational numbers such that they are difference. Difference means subtraction. Difference is rational. Okay, for these things, how can we can take two irrational numbers such that their difference will be rational? In this, for these questions, we have to take two irrational numbers such that their irrational part should be equal. If the irrational parts will equal, then when we subtract one from another, then the irrational part will be cancelled. So our form for this question is a plus root b and c plus root b, or a minus root b and c minus root b. The irrational parts should be equal. So for an example, 5 plus root 3 and 8 plus root 3. Okay, so here irrational part are same. So when we subtract, so 5 plus root 3 minus 8 plus root 3. So our result will be 5 plus root 3 minus 8 minus root 3. So minus root 3 and plus root 3 cancel. 5 minus 8 is equals to minus 3, which is an rational number. We can take also another examples, 3 plus 2 root 5 and 3 8 plus 2 root 5. So if we subtract them, what will the result? 3 plus 2 root 5 minus 8 plus 2 root 5. So answer is 3 plus 2 root 5 minus 8 minus 2 root 5. 2 root 5 root 5 will be cancelled. The result is minus 5. So which is a rational number. Understood? So now we'll do the question number 6. Find two irrational numbers such that their product is rational number. Find two irrational numbers such that their product, is rational numbers. Here, if we'll take two irrational numbers such that their irrational part are equal. In first question also, I have told you, but here the difference is, in question number 4 and 5, the irrational part is added to the rational part. So that in that case, they become the irrational numbers. But here, for this questions, the product, that means we have to take the product of irrational number and rational number so that it will become a rational number. Okay, so in this type we will take another irrational number and we have to see that the irrational part should be equal. Okay, so just like a root b and c root b. Here irrational part is root b and root b is multiplied by a, or
Here A and root B are multiplied. So if we take this type of number and when we multiply them or when we find out the product of these two numbers, then what will be the result? The result will become a rational number. Let us see. So for an example, 5 root 3 into 3 root 3. So what is the result? 5 into root 3 into 3 into root 3, which is equal to first rational into rational, 5 into 3 into root 3 into root 3. Our answer is 5 into 3 equal to 15 into root 3 into root 3 equal to 3 equal to 45, which is an rational number. Okay. So similarly, if we take another example, suppose 2 root 5 into 5 root 5. What is our answer? 2 into 5 into root 5 into root 5 is equals 2 into 5, 10 into root 5 equal to 5, which is equals to 50. Okay. So this is a form of two irrational numbers such that their product will be rational. Okay. There is another one form of the irrational number such that their product will be rational. What is that form? Form is A plus root B and A minus root B. Okay. If you take this type of numbers, then the product of these numbers will be a rational number. For example, 2 plus root 5 and 2 minus root 5. That means if we multiply 2 plus root 5 into 2 minus root 5, here you can see that treat 2 as A and B as root 5. Here A plus B and here A minus B. What is the formula? We have already learned that A plus B into A minus B equal to A square minus B square. So putting this formula, so A square means 2 square minus B square means root 5 square. The result is 4 minus root 5 whole square equal to 5, which is equal to minus 1. So in this way also we can find out two irrational number such that their product will be rational number. So for these questions there are two forms. One is A root B and C root B, and another one form is A plus root B and A minus root B. And in question number 7, it is given that find two irrational numbers such that their quotient will be is an rational. Quotient is rational. So here again we need another one form. Already we have already discussed about this type of questions in while we have read the chapters. Okay, unit of this chapters. So let us find two irrational numbers. That means we have to find out two irrational numbers such that if we divide one irrational number by another one, then our result will be the rational number. That means the quotient will be rational. So for this question, same type of question forms we can take A root B and C root B. For an example, 8 root 2 and 4 root 2. So when we divide them, then what will the result? 8 root 2 divided by 4 root 2. So root 2 root 2 cancel. Answer is 8 by 4 is equal to 1 by 2. Which is equal to 2, which is an rational number. Okay. Similarly, if we take 3 root 5 and 5 root 5. So when we divide one by another, so the result will be 3 root 5 divided by 5 root 5. Then root 5 root 5 cancel. This is equal to 3 by 5, which is a rational number. So this is a quotient which is a rational number. So in this way, we have find out the numbers, so two numbers such that their product, their division, their addition and their subtraction will be rational number. You have to only keep this form in your mind so that when any type of question will come, you can find out. Okay, so let's bye. And in next video, we'll do the exercise. There are the rest questions of the exercise, that is insert of two rational numbers or more rational numbers in between two rational numbers and the rest questions. Okay, so till then, goodbye.